Before I start, I will apologize everyone for being late. I'm not well versed with this Zoom meeting and all. To start with, Arup, as most of you are familiar, and Sharon has also given you a brief introduction. I'm based in Ahmedabad, Gujarat. And since a couple of years, we are trying to document butterflies of Gujarat. We are exploring various places and doing that. And most of us, some of us are into academic background, some are in non-academic background, and they all are contributing this wonderful documentation work. I'm a freelance consultant for ecology and biodiversity. And along with that, I'm visiting faculty with Gujarat University. I have my own enterprise called Green Cover. I'm also working voluntarily in Northeast as well as in Mumbai for education and research initiatives. So that's all about me. I think we can start now. Shall we, Sharon? So before we jump to butterflies, let us understand a bit some of the things about Gujarat. As you can see, it is the fifth largest state in terms of area, spreading about 1,96,000 square kilometers. And it is why I am sharing this, because some of the border areas are very interesting when it comes to butterflying. We share our border with Pakistan and Rajasthan in northeast, then Madhya Pradesh in east, Maharashtra and Union Territories in south part. So as far as butterflies are concerned, some of the Sindh region butterflies can be encountered in the eastern part. So that's how border of Pakistan and Rajasthan becomes very significant. Besides terrestrial part, we have a very long coastal border, the longest coastal border of 1600 kilometers. So we have coastal part as well. So in overall, this makes Gujarat a very interesting from the geographical perspective, that it has seashore as well as a huge, does a huge coastal line, and at the same time it has desert and hilly forest. Also down there it shares border with Maharashtra, which is the tip of northwestern part. When it comes to climate, our winters are from November to February, summer from March to May, and June October is a monsoon time. For butterflying, monsoon to post-monsoon time remains very good. So October onwards, October, November is fairly good time. We do not get, unlike other parts, we do not get a very elaborated time for butterflying. Because till June, July, August, it's heavy rains. September, still as rain are receding, it is not very great time for butterflying. So we do not get much time. If one season is gone, that means a whole year is gone. It goes like that. So, unlike other states, you can see when the rainfall is it varies greatly, like 340 mm in the western region of Kutch to 1800 mm in the south Gujarat. So according to, you all are aware that butterflies are a bit of martial living. So depending upon this rainfall gradient, we have different species distributed in the state. On an average rainfall is 800 millimeters throughout the state. Climate varies from dry subhumid in Kutch and Valsad district, arid in Kutch. So we can see the gradient of aridity also, that we have arid regions, we have semi-arid regions, and we also have humid parts as in South Gujarat. So biogeographically, because of this climate gradient, we have different habitats all over the state. So we can see wonderful grasslands in Kutch and Saurashtra region, also in Saurashtra, also in the central part. So in these grassland regions, we have some unique butterflies like joker appearing in this part. We also have coastal ecosystems such as mangroves, coral reefs, and they are the part of the western coastline entirely, western to the south coastline. And in this mangroves also, we have come across some interesting observations, and Some of the species like palm fly, they are, we have seen that they are restricted to coastal area only as of now. We do not have any reports of palm fly from central or northern parts. We also have saline desert in Kutch, Bhavnagar and all these places. So there also, interestingly, we have come across some species where one could expect, like being an arid and marine area, I mean saline area, we may not find life, but in these parts also we have come across some good observations. So as we move to southern parts, we have moist deciduous forest, and we can find also hilly forests along the entire eastern line, right from Aravalli north to the south Gujarat part, the northwestern parts. Also in Saurashtra regions, we have some hilly parts. So entire eastern belt have been very nice for us to explore for butterflying. Because of a discontinuous hilly forest area. In these areas, we have some the ranges which we include, which includes Aravallis, Vindhyas, Satpura, as well as Sahyadri. So Gujarat might be only one such state where you will find this various hill ranges which start from Gujarat. As we move from north to south, vegetation gets denser, and because of which butterfly diversity is more in South Gujarat. Vegetation as well as humidity is high in South Gujarat. In photographs, you can see the upper one is from Sabarkantha, Poro Forest. Then there is Maunder Hills, then Ratan Mahal Wildlife Sanctuary, and last one is Dangs. So from the picture itself, it's evident that how the city areas vary from each other. So about 19,000 square kilometer of forest area we have, and of which 17,000 has been declared as protected area. I think some of the portion got cut. So when this kind of varied habitats are there, it is important to classify them into some kind of forest type system. So as per Champions said, they have given, as per this classification system, we have some 16 major forest types all over the country. So forest doesn't mean just trees, number of trees and the density per area, but it depends upon the overall composition of flora. So we have, in Gujarat, we have four main types: tropical moist deciduous forest, littoral and swamp forest, tropical dry deciduous forest, and northern tropical thorn forest. The tropical moist deciduous forest, we find where average annual rainfall is over 1200. So these kind of forests, the moist deciduous forests, are restricted to the north western parts, that is Surat, Valsad and Dangs, or in other words, southmost and southernmost part of the state. Littoral and swamp forests are the mangrove forests, which are the intertidal areas of the state. As I mentioned, that we have longest coastline of 1600 kilometers. So this forests, they form very integral part along the coastal line. Tropical dry forests are distributed in regions where rainfall is between 1600 millimeter to 1200 millimeter. So these are mainly the central part, which includes districts like Bharuch, Baroda, Panchmahal, Sabarkantha, certain parts of Saurashtra, Amreli district, Junagadh and Jamnagar. So these are the areas where one will find tropical dry deciduous forest. And lastly comes the tropical thorn forest, northern tropical thorn forest. So these are the forests where rainfall is less than 600 millimeter. And this kind of forest we'll find in Kutch, Banaskantha, Rajkot. Parts of Bhavnagar, all these areas we'll find this kind of tropical thorn forest. To ease our studies, we decided, initially I was thinking of taking up national parks and sanctuary areas for our study. Then I thought that since we have different habitats, so it is better to pick up the study as per habitats. So the easiest way was to go by the agroclimatic zones, easy rather the convenient way, so by which we can cover most of the habitats. So basically Gujarat is divided into 8 different agroclimatic zones. This zoning is given by Agriculture and Cooperation Department of Government of Gujarat. So the 8 zones include lower southern Gujarat, and you can see these areas are well marked in map also. Zone 2 is upper southern Gujarat. Zone 3 is middle Gujarat. Zone 4 is northern Gujarat. 5 includes northwestern zone. 6 zone is northern Saurashtra. 7 is southern Saurashtra. And 8 is Highland coastal area. Now each of these areas, I discussed earlier, that they have their own set of climatic condition, and because of which they have their own kind of vegetation as well. We have covered almost all these zones. We did extensive surveys. This survey started back in 2014. So during that time, zone 5 we covered extensively, zone 1 and 2 also we covered extensively. And gradually we moved to zone 3 and 4. Zone 4 is yet to be explored in depth, and zone 7 also we are done. So during all these surveys, we came out with very, I will share later on all the interesting studies that we have found. For this, we have a huge team. I'm putting up just few names over here. Butterfly survey was initiated with Kshitish and Mahesh Bhate. Kshitish Kumar is presently in US pursuing his work over there. But initial, the maximum surveys that I mentioned, that Kutch, South Gujarat, Sabarkantha, Banaskantha, Ratan Mahal, Jaisal, all these areas are explored with Kshitish and Mahesh. Mohit Patel, he is from Surat. He also came with us. He was also there in this service. And let me tell you that when it comes to butterfly taxonomy, Mohit is very resourceful. I put mentioned name of one young chap, Lalit Makwana. He is just a kid, but still, when it comes to knowledge of butterflying and spotting butterflying in field, is simply excellent. We have Ashish Chaudhary, Meruwariya from Surat. Ashish Chaudhary has done extensive work in South Gujarat. He has explored a lot of those places and he has always willingly assisted me in these areas. Meruwariya is from Anand as well as from Surat. He has done his studies, in fact, his dissertation on butterflies of Anand. And during these surveys, both Ashish and Mayur, they have come out with some very interesting first records from Gujarat. Some of them happens to be the first photographic records from Gujarat. Shivam Bhatt, who is from Rajkot, from Saurashtra area, he is coming out with wonderful observations. Dr. Monika Shah, she is working with schools. She is based in Ahmedabad, and that wonderful conservation work she has taken up. Presently, Dr. Rajesh Chandar and Drupad Patel, they have been my backbone when it comes to butterfly surveys in this phase. I must mention that in 2016, I was taken down by a health issue and it was difficult for me to go to field. Dr. Chandan had been my doctor on field all the time and still he is helping me out. So that has been big help when currently in carrying out all the surveys. There are three names I would like to mention: Ms. Lakshmi Pillai, Suchi Gandhi and Devanshi Patel. These three wonderful women, they are doing their PhD on butterflies. In fact, Suchi Gandhi is done with her PhD. So Devanshi is working in Bhavnagar, whereas Lakshmi is documenting butterflies of one very interesting region, which is Pavagarh. So we are waiting for her observations also to come out. As far as I got to know from other people as well that besides these three girls, there are some other people also who are now taking interest academically into butterflies, and which is definitely required. Like Mayur did the survey of this college area, Lakshmi is doing for Pavagarh, Suchi did for Baroda, Devanshi is doing for Bhavnagar. It is not possible for a small butterflying team to reach all the areas. So I'm glad that gradually butterflying is picking up in Gujarat as compared to the other state where people are preparing entire checklist of the state. Here we do not have that structure still now. So gradually people are taking interest, they are coming to field and they are making those documentations. So to generate awareness, we organized 4 butterfly meets or festivals so far. The very first butterfly meet of Gujarat was in 2015. And let me tell you, in all these butterfly meets and festival, Peter Smetachek sir had supported us a lot. In 2015, then I was going to organize the first butterfly meet. I was thinking of organizing. I spoke to Peter sir that we do not get enough species when we go for butterfly walk. will it be a good idea? They supported that number of species does not matter. What matters is to generate awareness. So if you start generating awareness, more and more people will start taking interest and they'll start making observations. So the very first butterfly meet was organized with the help of the Serenity Library in Botanical Garden. Wilderness India, I'm sorry, I misspelled the name. I'm sorry. It's Wilderness India. And South Gujarat Forest Department, our division, South Dang Division, helped us in organizing this very first initiative. Second butterfly meet we organized at Bapur in Panchmahal district. And third one, I thought that we are done with the meet and it's time to have some basic course kind of structure where people get to know how to identify butterflies. So Peter sir also was all in for it. So we went for basic course, which he usually conducts at Dean Tal. So he showed his willingness that I'll conduct basic course for you people so that people, so the students who cannot go around to Dean Tal will get benefit of this knowledge. So this we had organized in 2017. And the last butterfly meet, that was in 2018, we organized at Gir, the place which gets all the attention for lions. So it was again it was like taking a chance that where people come to see lions, will people take interest in butterflies? But even that butterfly meet, we made a huge success. We received very good participation. 2019, we could not organize because of heavy rains over here. So we are looking forward. Let's see how Corona atmosphere goes, so we can organize one in 2020 now. So during all this travel and documentation, there are some interesting observations that we came across that I'll share with you all. This Indian safari we came across in Kutch, and specifically Isaac sir has mentioned in his book that one can find Indian safari at Kala Dunga. So this is again like how in depth our people like Ajit sir have worked that they can give you the exact place also. As we climbed Kala Dunga after traveling more than 120 kilometers and bang on, we found Indian Fritillary. Afterwards, like growing interest in butterfly among people, usually I came across a few photographs where people have labeled Indian Fritillary as common leopard or as maybe tiger as well. So now, students and other wildlife people who are working in Kutch, even they are reporting Indian Fritillary from various other parts of Kutch. So most of the interesting observations are again coming from Kutch, because in southern part the species that we get, they will be commonly found in western parts. So the species, most of the species that we find in Kutch will be unique for you people. Again, blue-spotted Arab, we have its distribution restricted to Kutch region, greater run of Kutch, not even little run. But there is one secluded report of blue-spotted Arab's presence in Amreli district. Sorry, I missed out the Arab. It's a very unique and beautiful butterfly. Like it looks like white Arab, but with orange and blue tinge. Indian Pierrot or Taruca sylvica, initially spotted one in Kutch, and we presume that its distribution is restricted to then arid parts only, in as far as Gujarat is concerned. But as we traveled further down, so where people had difficulty in identifying the difference between tarucas, that's where this identity was getting lost. In fact, I found it near my house only, where I stay. This was one very interesting observation in Gir. I was accompanied by Drupad and Kalpit Gangar, and we were exploring a certain patch of Tectona. And Lalit, he spotted something flying, and he showed me this something went away. And when he is spotting something, like, I do take it seriously. So we just turned few leaves and we found tricolor pipelet, and this is the most like northwestern record of this particular species. Otherwise, tricolor pipelet is restricted to southern parts. Rest what this observation was made by Mayur. The way I said that quite a good species are might be common for the people who are butterflying in south, people who are butterflying in Western Ghats. But some such species are very much unique for us, like red spot, monkey puzzle, ape fly, peacock royal, orchid tit. These species are very, very rare for us. They are restricted to southern Gujarat only. And that too, we have very rare observations for these kind of species, maybe two or three. This is only, I'm sharing some beautiful moments that we came across. In Gujarat, we do not find usually like a huge mud puddling places or very huge gathering of butterflies. So this was in Gir when I just happened to see an entire yellow carpet. My camera couldn't capture more than this, but it was a whole good yellow carpet of grass yellows. Mud puddling in such huge numbers is very uncommon here. When it comes to coastal butterflies, I was not expecting species like Black Raja, Plain Tigers in the spot. This is from Dwarka area. So this is Doryphosa and Chrysippus form which are mating. And in this particular area where you all know that Chrysippus is very common form and Doryphosa is a bit uncommon. But in particular Dwarka area, we found a lot of Doryphosa and barely there was one or two Chrysippus within them. It was rather more of Doryphosa and where to search for Chrysippus in those crowd. So when we explored in Gir and Porbandar and all these areas, we could see that Doryphosa is more common in the western part of Gujarat rather than this side. So maybe that kind of gradient is due to habitat. Finding all such species on one twig was also a very interesting observation, and it remained quite a good, we could observe this for a couple of days. I'll conclude with one of my favorite observations, that is of Tony Silverline, Cigarettes Acamas. So both Tony Silverline and Indian Fritillary, we found on the same day. It was a very delightful moment. For Tony Silverline also, we have found it so far in greater one of Kutch area only. And still I hope that we should find somewhere near LRK border as well. So I'll thank you all with Tony Silverline. If there are any questions, I'll be happy to answer.
Hi, this is Sharon here. So can you tell us a rough checklist on Gujarat butterflies?
I would say like unlike other states where we have complete checklist ready with us, still it is difficult to conclude. Preliminary work was preliminary work was done by Shell, but it was done between 1940s and 60s, and it was done in southern Gujarat. Mm-hmm. According to him, there were around 190 species, but again, quite a good Western Ghats species were included, and the species which were cited just once or twice were there. So we decided that first-hand survey is very much required, and that's why we initiated this. So roughly, like my own checklist stands around 125. And if I add other people's observation as well, so it will go around not more than 150. It has to be around 150 something.
Okay.
So I think we'll take this season as well. I hope situations support us.